How to lose weight or how to lose fat, since the vast majority of extra weight in our bodies is fat. How to lose belly fat, arm fat, thigh fat, all fat everywhere, and make sure that the fat stays gone. How to achieve that great athlete physique with a body fat range between 6 and 14% for men and between 14 and 21% for women. Let's talk about 4 practical steps to achieve exactly that. Coming up. Hi, Andre here. Welcome to Practical Health. Let's be serious. Let me pull out the pillow. Okay, modern science is still learning about the human body and exactly how it works. One thing we understand more or less well is that the fat creation and fat breakdown processes are managed by 2 out of approximately 80 hormones found in every human body. These hormones are insulin, the fat storing hormone, and IGF, the insulin-like growth factor, otherwise known as the fat breaking hormone. We can essentially rephrase the question, how do we lose fat, as how do we decrease the level of insulin and increase the levels of IGF in our bodies? Just as a quick disclaimer, the human body is a complex system, managed by various processes. So what we're talking about is a simplified framework for the average person to lose fat. We're skipping interim steps such as glycogen creation, breakage, and others, along with the way in which growth hormone, ghrelin, leptin, glucagon, and other hormones impact the weight management process. With that out of the way, let's answer the question, what are the steps towards losing fat? Step 1. Understand your personal calorie balance. This is basically the difference between the number of calories that you consume versus the number of calories that you expend. Luckily, both of these quantities are quite easily measurable. We consume calories through what we eat and drink, proteins, fat, and carbs, and our bodies spend calories all the time without us needing to think about it, because they cool like that. Calories are spent on our body's basic operations, called our basal metabolic rate, and also we expend calories through the activity that we do throughout the day, called active energy. Depending on whom you listen to, some people might say that calculating calorie balance is unnecessary. And there is some reasoning behind this position, which we'll discuss in a future video. For our purposes, if you're serious about your health and weight control, I strongly recommend you to calculate your calorie balance for several days at least. This will help you to understand in detail how your calorie consume bucket compares to your calorie spend bucket and make sure that currently you don't create the fat in your body. This information is critical and will serve as your foundation for the next steps. Step 2. Create a negative calorie balance, so that the level of your calories consumed bucket is lower than the level of your calories spent bucket. Now, there are 2 basic levers to do this. Either reduce calorie intake or increase the calorie expenditure, or ideally both. Regarding reducing your calorie intake, there are many different tactics that you can do. Minimize consumption of calorie-heavy carbs, and especially sweets. Increase the percentage of proteins and vegetables in your diet. Minimize the size of your portions, and so on, and others. There are many tactics to reduce your calorie intake, and we'll talk about them in an upcoming video. Now for the second lever, spending more energy. Is it possible to lose weight without having an active lifestyle? Probably yes, but it's extremely tough, and likely not worth the added challenge, unless you're really hardcore. Instead, try to find a way to increase your activity level by taking part in low-intensity activities like walking or taking stairs instead of the elevator. Also, try to include medium and high-intensity activities like running, cycling, rowing, dancing, boxing, whatever. Doing this will have multiple positive effects, like increasing your calorie expenditure, increasing your metabolism and basal metabolic rate, and it will simply minimize the period of time in which you can eat or overeat. You may also want to consider lowering the temperature in your room, so that your body will spend more energy to keep itself warm. Step 3. Use your body fat as the energy source to cover your negative calorie balance. What we're talking about is increasing the level of IGF in your body. Two basic points here. Number one, minimize calorie intake to just 2-3 times a day. And number two, reduce the total window of time that you take in calories throughout the day to 12 hours. For instance, from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. You may already be familiar with the term intermittent fasting, and its most popular mode of 16-8. 16 hours of fasting, no food, no snacks, no calories, maybe from 5 p.m. to 9 a.m., followed by 8 hours of food intake. Personally, I found that 16 hours of fasting per day led to quite a lot of stress on my body. So you should try to find a good balance for yourself between maximizing your no-food window and keeping your daily routine sustainable. Through a little trial and error process, I found that my sweet spot is a 12-hour fasting window between about 6:30 p.m. and 6:30 a.m. Creating a daily no-food or fasting window is a critical step. The ultimate goal is to have a good window during the day when insulin goes down and IGF levels go up to convert the body fat into glucose. This process is called ketosis, a normal metabolic process to burn stored fat. Let's repeat this last bit. Decreasing the insulin and increasing IGF will speed up the breakdown of fat and provide you with the energy you need. This is exactly what we are looking for. Losing fat and sustaining a good level of energy. Limiting your food intake window to 12 hours can help you solve this problem. You definitely want to avoid the worst case scenario, which would be eating fewer calories throughout the day, but constantly snacking day and night. If you do this, your insulin levels will stay high and your IGF levels will stay low for the entire 24-hour period. Meaning you won't break down any fat in your body and will have a low energy throughout the day. This pitfall is where many weight loss dreams fall apart. As an analogy, imagine if your typical 10-hour workday were actually 18 hours a day, but broken into smaller portions. I guarantee you would hate it, your performance would be terrible, and you'd be tired constantly, and probably you'd quit really fast. Now the final step, step 4. Design a new calorie-controlled diet that limits food intake windows and ensure that physical activities are a part of your everyday life. You want to strive for a great cumulative effect over time. Losing fat is a gradual process that will take a significant amount of time, so you need to change your lifestyle to lose weight. Let's put it into perspective. 1 gram of body fat will give you 9 calories of energy. So your daily 500 calorie negative balance will enable you to lose about 55 grams of fat per day. This means that to lose 10 pounds of fat, it will take you about 3 months, assuming you won't have any cheat dates. It's a long period of time, so you must commit and be ready to change your old habits by replacing them with new healthy ones. In my experience, changing habits is not a linear process. There will be ups and downs and sideways. Stick to the plan and you can get there. Building a habit takes anywhere between 18 and 256 days, with the median being 66 days. Consider changing habits one by one. First, for example, increase your level of physical activities. Then focus on shifting your diet from carbs to proteins. Then begin to minimize your food intake window, and so on, rather than trying to tackle everything at once. When new habits are formed, they create psychological changes in your mind and become a part of your DNA. So sticking to the plan becomes much, much easier. That's all for today. Now you have a clear path toward losing fat and keeping it off. If you enjoyed the video, spend a couple of calories on clicking that like button and typing up a comment. Even a simple comment like, I see, losing weight is really a gradual process, will help our small channel grow. And rumor has it that subscribing to Practical Health channel makes you lose 2 pounds instantly. Give it a try. See you next time. Bye.